What's going on, everybody, and welcome back to the Chicago Bears franchise. It's time for Week 11 football as the Bears meet the Packers for the first time this season. Chicago still unbeaten through 10 games, and of course, this defense is still untouchable. This is definitely one of the hardest groups to score on in the league, and of course, the Packers would love to change that and put the Bears in the loss column for the first time this year. And we'll see what kind of start the Packers can get off to this week as they will receive the opening kickoff. And here's TJ Cartwright sending it deep in. Randall Cobb from the 6-yard line working this one upfield and running right into Alex Anzalone as he's taken down shy of the 25. And out comes Aaron Rodgers. This is going to be quite the offensive matchup to watch this week as Rodgers currently leads the MVP voting through 11 weeks, but of course there's a rookie running back from Chicago, Freddie Finnelis, right behind him at number 2. Green Bay starts empty on 1st and 10, and a complete throw to Davante Adams. That's Rodriguez Beasley giving up 8 yards to get the game going. Now going to a shotgun look with Ty Montgomery in the backfield to give to him on 2nd down. Montgomery spins to the 40. Nice start for the Packers already. There's another 8-yard play. 1st and 5 from the 46 after an encroachment call. Montgomery gets loose again. Run defense for Chicago kind of shaky right now. Ty Montgomery to the Bears 43. Ramirez in motion. Rodgers hands off once again. Montgomery this time is stood up and put down. There's Pierce Stevens howling. Only good for 1. 2nd down from the 42. Rodgers trips left. Takes his time. Check down to Adams. That's caught at the 36. And Davante Adams a bit slow to get up there, holding his forearm. He's tackled by Russell McIntyre, and he'll have to leave the field. That could be a huge loss for Green Bay in the first drive of the ball game. 3rd down and 2 for the Packers. It's Ty Montgomery getting shut down. Henry Wong coming off the edge untouched. And 4th down, Green Bay forced to kick the field goal. What a stand by Chicago. Bend but don't break is the name of the game. No Mason Crosby here for the Packers. It's Chandler Catanzaro from 53 yards. Kick on the way, and this kick is wide right, not even close. Chicago still has yet to trail in any game this season, and now they start from the 43. 1st and 10, Mitchell Trubisky handing off to Freddie Finnelis to get the game going for Chicago's offense, and the rookie finds 5 yards. A little bit of a lackluster game last week compared to previous showings, but still a solid season. Now a play fake on 2nd down, Trubisky plenty of time and finding Jesse James inside the 30, and Chicago down to the Green Bay 29 on 2 plays. Can't give Trubisky that kind of time. Now 1st and 10. Screen left to Collins, and Collins kind of trips over himself there and loses 3 yards. From the 32, Trubisky with time throws right to Collins, who makes the grab with the soft coverage from Randall. And now Chicago's in the red zone. From the 15-yard line, Trubisky hands off right to Finnelis, and that's going to be Mike Daniels with the stop there. Finnelis kept to a 2-yard gain. From the 13, Trubisky this time throwing, looking left for Meredith, who's down to the 7. Nice play there against the rookie Morgan Rudolph, who the Packers picked up in the first round. 2 yards to go from the 7-yard line, and the Bears find the first. Here's Finnelis working to the right side, and big play there from Nick Perry. Poor block there from Shaheen, and Chicago kept to 3. Green Bay's offense back out there on the field. Here's Rodgers from the 29 under pressure. Checks it down to the flat, and Martellus Bennett to the 39. Still wearing a Green Bay uniform, apparently. Thought he would have been gone by now. Trips right for Green Bay on 2nd and short. Rodgers looking for something down the field. Steps around in the pocket. Throws to Cobb, and is intercepted. Marlon Humphrey back the other way inside the 10. And he's not going to be caught. That's a touchdown for the Bears. And it's the defense coming through again. This might be one of the highest scoring defenses in the league as Aaron Rodgers makes a pretty horrible decision there. You have plenty of time and deciding to step around and throw off balance to the sideline where the defense is lurking. Marlon Humphrey with another interception this year. That's number 2 for him. He has really adopted the slot role very well. 10-point Bears lead here in the first quarter, and Rodgers play fake, looking for something down the field, trying to strike back against Chicago, but testing the wrong corner. Good coverage by Beasley. 2nd down for the Packers. Here's Rodgers handing off to Ty Montgomery, who's slowed up and put down by Trey Canada. There's a short gain of 3. 3rd and 7 now for the Packers. Chicago making a shift on defense. Rodgers underneath. There's Ardarius Stewart, who can't get the first down. Taken down a couple of yards shy and Chicago gets the stop again. Things are going pretty normal for Chicago right now. 10-point lead at the offense with the ball late in the first quarter. Here's Trubisky on the underneath throw to Collins. And tackled by Rudolph, shy of the first down. Already with his third catch of the ball game here. Second and short. The Bears go I formation. Here's Finneles getting across midfield. Clinton Dix can't close the gap. Freddie Finneles down the sideline. Rudolph can't get there in time. And it's Finneles to the end zone again. You have got to respect this run game. His 13th rushing touchdown this season. It just comes down to great blocking. Collins took care of Randall. Gave him enough of a gap to get this one up the field and around Clinton Dix for the score. What a play and what a ball game so far for the Bears. Not a lot of time left in the first for Green Bay to get something going. Here's Rodgers with no one open, trying to take off the run, and he's taken down. It's Jalen Smith with the sack. That was a doomed play from the jump. 3rd and 9 now for Green Bay, 45 seconds on the clock in the first. Rodgers trying to take off the run here as he throws to the sideline for Montgomery, and that's not going to move the chains. First quarter dominated by the Bears. Here's the beginning of the second quarter. Trubisky from the shotgun and trying to find something down the field here. Trubisky rolls right. Solid coverage from the Packers as no one gets open in time, and Mitch just throws it away. 3rd down, 9 yards to go. Trubisky steps up and is drilled by Ryan, trying to find someone down the field, and that's going to be incomplete. Chicago goes 3 and out this time around. That's a big stop for Green Bay, trying to get back in the ball game. 1st and 10 from their own 23. Here is Rodgers rolling to the right side and floats one over the top of the defense and finding Cobb. That'll get them to the 41. Nice little play there from Green Bay. Ramirez in motion once again. Here's Montgomery with the carry, and he's picked up and shut down by Trey Canada. Nice stuff there for a loss of 2. Backed up again on 2nd down, now facing 3rd and 14. Green Bay trying to move the chains. Rodgers checking it down to Montgomery, trying to move the chains and taken down shy of the first. Marlon Humphrey comes through again. Nice start for number 35 this week. Chicago gets going from the 23, and Trubisky threading the needle, finding Cameron Meredith for his 6th completion of the ball game. 6-for-8 start, not bad. Green Bay just looks confused. From the 49, here's Trubisky handing off to Finneles, who gets away from the defense again. Collins is clearing these lanes, and Finneles going 49 yards to the end zone for the touchdown. This offensive line is not playing around with Green Bay this week. They are dominating up front. Down by 24 points and trying to get something going before the first half comes to a close, and not much there for Ty Montgomery. Only a yard. They've really got to think about opening up this pass game here. Here's a 2nd down throw from Rodgers on target to Cabo. Gets away from Beasley and races across midfield to the Chicago 42. Nice tackle there from Adrian Amos. And that's Green Bay with their best play so far. Still no sign of Davante Adams. Here's Montgomery on 1st down, carrying through a lane and taken down shy of the 1st down. And it's Green Bay back in kick range for Catanzaro, hopefully this time around, as Montgomery carries ahead and not going to worry about the field goal quite yet. Nice run up the middle, and that's going to move the chains for the Packers. From the 29-yard line, here's Rodgers from the pistol. Steps up, trying to run with it, and taken down quickly by Humphrey. Kept the 2 yards, but a false start will back them up to 3rd and 11. Williams checks in. Rodgers with time, looking to the right side, and that was luckily thrown into the dirt because there were 3 Bears there. Could have very easily been picked off by someone. Here's another try from Catanzaro. This kick on the way, and this kick is surprisingly good. Kicking against the wind this time around. Green Bay's on the board. It's 24-3. Still a lot of time for Chicago to do some damage in the first half, but starting 1st and 20 after a holding call, and Trubisky off in time. There's Adam Shaheen. That'll get Chicago back to the original line of scrimmage. 2nd and 10 for Chicago. Split back look. Here's Trubisky looking, and a high throw for Collins. That is caught for a decent game, but still 3rd and 5 to go. Can the Bears move the chains here? Cohen checks in on 3rd down again. Trubisky against a blitz, trying to find Richardson for the first time this game. He has had a very quiet season, and Trubisky just can't hit him in stride. On the send, this one back to Green Bay is Pat O'Donnell. This kick is carried by the wind. Cobb lets it go, and that might have been a mistake as it rolls inside the Green Bay 10 and down at the 3. How does Pat O'Donnell do this? Green Bay in trouble now, backed up inside their own 5-yard line. Randall Cobb in motion. Here's a give to Montgomery, and able to find a little bit of space there. There's Cortland Porton with the tackle as Montgomery picks up 6. 2-minute warning just hit from the 9-yard line. High snap, delayed give to Montgomery. That is Fuller with the tackle, and that's not a first down quite yet. Chicago stacking the box here, expecting run. Here's a blitz on the way and a screen off in time. Montgomery gets the first down, and Chicago gives up a huge play. And now it's Green Bay from the 23. Still a long way to go, but still 3 timeouts to work with. Off in the flats, there's Bradley all alone to the 32. And a 3rd and short for Green Bay again. Chicago stacks the box. Here comes another blitz as Rodgers didn't see it in time. Loose football scooped up by the Bears. It's Humphrey back the other way. He could get a 2nd touchdown. And he will. Forget the safety. Give us the touchdown again. Chicago now leads 30-3 as Pierce Stevens Helling is slow to get up. But at the pace this game is going, they might not need him. 25-yard line, 57 seconds on the clock. Here's Rodgers to the air, and this is tipped up in Humphrey. Nearly a 2nd interception. Just couldn't get that last foot in bounds. What a game for Marlon Humphrey. 3rd and 10 now for Green Bay. Handing off here to Montgomery, who's shut down by Trey Canada. And Chicago calls a timeout, looking to get some more points on the board. Already up 31-3, and starting from the 47, here's Trubisky with time and a check down to Adam Shaheen. Trubisky 9 of 12 for 95 yards in the first half, not much to do through the air. 2nd down, play fake, Trubisky looking and intercepted. That is not the right throw to make right there, and that is Jake Ryan with the pick. Trubisky a little too quick on the trigger there, and with 15 seconds left, Green Bay runs it once more. And we are heading to halftime. Chicago dominating once again. 31-3 is the score. We have not seen much from Green Bay this game, and that is not a good sign for them. 2nd half is coming up next. Things are not going well for the Green Bay Packers as they get this 2nd half going. And deep to return is Tariq Cohen for Chicago. Bringing this one out the end zone across the 20. And Cohen taken down shy of the 25 at the Bears 24. And out comes the Chicago offense. Already a 4-touchdown lead for Chicago. A lot of big plays from the ground game. Here's Trubisky to the air on 1st and 10. Looking down the field, he's got one-on-one coverage. And Demaryius Randall gets beat. It's Collins showboating from the 30, and no one even close. That score did not take long at all as Collins continues to terrorize these secondaries. He is going to challenge your number one corner. And if you don't have safety help up top, sometimes it's just catch and run. We've seen this time and time again this year. That is by far the easiest touchdown Collins is going to have this year. Nice start to the 2nd half for the Chicago offense. Can the defense follow suit? Rodgers, empty set on 1st and 10, takes off to run and slides under Marlon Humphrey for a decent gain. But obviously they have got to find a way to get this ball down the field a little more consistently. 2nd and 5, a give here to Ty Montgomery. And that run going nowhere. Trey Canada in the backfield again. 3rd down, Green Bay. 9 yards to go. Rodgers set up a screen to the left. And Montgomery spins through Jalen Smith, but not too much room to run on that play. And that's shut down by Cortland Porton and Henry Wong. 3 and out, Green Bay. Chicago's offense back on the field and obviously looking to give their defense a little break here in the 2nd half as they have been scoring consistently throughout this ball game. A lot of short drives. Keeping their defense on the field. There's Tariq Cohen for the 1st. Split back look on 1st down. Here's Howard carrying up the field into midfield. He's taken down by Jake Ryan. That carry good for 7. That's Howard's 1st. 3rd down, Chicago. Finneless in the backfield. Trubisky rolling to the right side. Stops, throws, and hits the rookie Cooper Lipinski, who's inside Green Bay territory. And Chicago in field goal range for Cartwright. There's 23 yards. Unfortunately, backed up due to a holding call. Here's 1st and 20 for Chicago as Trubisky's looking one-on-one down the field, trying to find Collins again. And that time, Randall in good position. 2nd and 20 for Chicago. Here's Trubisky from the gun. Play fake and stepping up in the pocket, trying to take off, and he's sacked. That's Adams with the play for the Packers, and Trubisky now slow to get up. That's his non-throwing shoulder, and it looks serious. Davis Webb checks in for the Bears on 3rd and 20, trying to move the chains here. Or maybe the Bears are just going to take the 3 points, as Cohen could have maybe taken at the distance if Rudolph didn't get in the way. 52-yard kick into the wind for TJ Cartwright. This kick is on the way in. The kick just barely clears the bottom goalpost. That is going to count. 41-3 your score here in the third quarter. Things are getting ugly quick for the Green Bay Packers. Here's Williams with the carry upfield and a nice powerful run there. Not seeing much of that from Ty Montgomery. Inches now to go for the Green Bay Packers. Here's a give to Montgomery. Slowed up by Portland. Put down by Russell McIntyre. 3 and out again. Green Bay just can't buy themselves a long drive. And out comes the Bears offense. And Trubisky looks good to go. Hopefully that shoulder's not in too much pain as Trubisky tries to run and is taken down quickly. There's Adams again. And that's going to be a 4-yard loss on the sack. Backed up to the 14-yard line. Bears going two tight ends plus putts here in the backfield. Trubisky with time underneath. There's James with the catch, and he gets hammered and luckily recovers his own fumble. Only a gain of one that play. 3rd and 13 now for the Bears. Trubisky looking to move the chains. He's hammered, and the ball's knocked free. It's scooped up by Green Bay. It's Kyrie King at the 15. This is not the drive the Bears won, and now Green Bay in perfect position. Kasheem Douglas on the right side giving up pressure to Nick Perry, who absolutely hammers Mitchell Trubisky, and unfortunately the Bears couldn't fall on it. That's going to put Green Bay in perfect position to get some more points here, although this game is probably out of reach. Aaron Rodgers from the shotgun on first down, steps up in the pocket and underneath to Randall Cobb, who's been a little bit quiet in this second half. He's kept to a decent gain of 7. Getting a stop here would be great for this Bears defense. Here's 2nd and 3 for Montgomery, carrying ahead and taken down by Amos shy of the first down. Here's 3rd and inches for the Green Bay Packers, 5 yards to go. Chicago stacks the box. Here's Rodgers to the air. Bears bring a blitz, but don't account for Montgomery. Open in the flat, and the Packers find the end zone for the first time in the game. And that's the first touchdown this Bears defense has given up in 3 games. It's now 10-41. Can the Bears offense find a way to shake off the turnover? Here's 2nd down for the Bears. Trubisky over the middle and open. There's Cameron Meredith against soft coverage. Gain of 17 to the Bears 40. Still finding ways to make plays. Third quarter winding down, under 30 seconds left, and Trubisky can't hit Collins. Good jarring hit there from Haha Clinton Dix. 28 seconds now left in the third quarter. Putts here in motion to the right side of the formation. Here's a give to Finnelis, finding some space, and Finnelis almost broke that one free. Physical run and a gain of 8 yards. Just shy of midfield here. 3rd down and 2 to begin the fourth quarter. Trubisky, a play fake, has time looking for Shaheen, and the pass sailed on him. 4th down, the Bears will punt this away to Green Bay. So the Packers score on the short field. Can they find a way to get a touchdown on a longer drive this time around from the 33? Here's a check down to Montgomery, and this is well defended by the Bears secondary, kept to a gain of 1. Gaining a couple yards on 2nd down. Here's 3rd and 5 for Rodgers. Steps up, has time, looks to run, gets it off in time to the flat again. And Montgomery there to move the chains. Green Bay now just shy of midfield. From the 47, Rodgers from the gun. It's the delay give to Ty Montgomery. Another strong run for him up the middle. And taken down again just shy of the first down marker. Looking to stop the drive right here. Here's Rodgers handing off to Williams, who slammed down as Henry Wong unblocked again. How do you forget to block that man? He's 300 pounds and 6'7". 3rd down and 4 now for Green Bay. Rodgers trying to run. This is not going to get the first down. It's Deshaunta White with the play. A little zone blitz there from the Bears, and White in perfect position to make his first tackle. 4th down, Green Bay punts it back. What a showing here from Chicago's defense this week. They are playing some lights out football. Here's Trubisky on 1st down to the right side as Finnelis gets a couple but can't stay in bounds. 2nd down after the gain of 4 yards. Trubisky to the air, has a man over the middle. There's Adam Shaheen holding on for the catch as there's an injury timeout. And it looks like that's Martinez for Green Bay. That does not look good, grasping at his ankle, and that's going to force him to leave the field. 2nd down for the Bears. Here's a give to Finnelis to the left side as the blocking kind of broke down there. third down. Trubisky looking to move the chains, looking to the right side. He is Collins again. Another great route. He gets open for the first, and Collins to the Green Bay 40. And this second-ranked Packers defense has no answer for anything this Bears offense is doing in this game. Second and seven, going to a screen, and that's pretty poorly blocked, if you can call that blocking. Jake Ryan forcing a four-yard loss. Now third and long for Chicago. 11 yards to go. Here's Shaheen, who's wide open. What a weird play call there from Green Bay. They give up another first down. Inside the 30, now facing third down again. 10 yards to go from the 24. Plenty of time against a three-man rush as Trubisky rolls out to the left, stops and throws, and this is nearly intercepted. Jake Ryan almost got there again. Paul Richardson the target, but Clark was open near the sideline. Got to make the smart throw. Now a 41-yard attempt from TJ Cartwright, and the kick's blocked. Green Bay going to run it back. It's Jason Jones with Webb pursuing. And that's going to put Green Bay on the board with another touchdown. It's now 16-41. And that, unfortunately, is the first miss for Cartwright this season. That is pretty unfortunate. Still, however, one of the most accurate kickers in the league. First down gift here after recovering the onside kick. And Finnell is trying to put this game on ice. A little over 2 minutes left as the number three Packers run defense is getting bolted over this game. Second down, here's Finnell to the left side. He's hit hard by Ryan and is scooped up by Randall. Collins trying to give chase. What is going on in the fourth quarter? Just end the game. Take a knee. Do what you need to do. This is way too many points to be given up this late in the game as Finnell fumbles for only the third time this year. But that does cut the lead to 41-23. Another onside kick recovered in Chicago trying to put this game on ice for real, but now facing third down. Clock stopped at 127. Here's third and eight for Chicago. Trubisky looking for Meredith and not the right read there. Has Shaheen deeper down the field. Chicago just tacks on 3 points, makes it a 21-point ball game. Here's Rodgers with a little time left in the fourth quarter and out to the sideline for Bradley. He's going to pick up around six. Minute 15 to go. Empty set now for Green Bay. Blitz on the way. Rodgers trying to run to the right side, and that's not going to move anything down the field. He's sacked for a six-yard loss. Crowd on their feet for third down and 10. Rodgers looking for something. Here's a throw down the field for Cobb, and this is well underthrown and definitely not the right throw to make. Rodriguez Beasley his third pick of the season and couldn't get a good block there from Marlon Humphrey. Possibly could have run that one back for a touchdown. So despite the fourth quarter drama, Chicago does win the game again. It's 44-23, and Chicago's perfect season continues, now 10-0 on the year. And it's time to start really diving into some of this division football. Chicago looks to wrap up this NFC North division. Even with the loss, Green Bay is not too far behind. We could see them land a wild card spot, but they've got a lot of work to do if they want to get back on track. Chicago just playing some solid football this season. 18 of 31 goes Trubisky for a touchdown plus the interception. Threw for 264, but we would like to see a little more production out of Trubisky in the end zone. Getting a lot more touchdowns, of course. That's where Freddie Finnellis comes in the red zone. Collins, a great game. The Bears getting pressure on Aaron Rodgers this game, forcing a couple of interceptions. Of course, Marlon Humphrey with the pick six and the fumble recovery. That was pretty big. On the other end, Aaron Rodgers goes 21 of 30, throwing 70%, which is pretty solid, but unfortunately two interceptions. They couldn't run the ball very well this game either. And through the air, losing Davante Adams pretty early in the ball game definitely hurt Green Bay's offensive production. This was not a great game for either team. Chicago 3 of 10 on third downs and looking to improve that as we take on the Detroit Lions in week 12. They're 4-6, we're 10-0. This is a Thanksgiving matchup for Chicago, one of the first in the series, I believe, as we take on Detroit at 12:30. And unfortunate news for Pierce Stevens howling out for 3 weeks with a shoulder tear, but Detroit's injury bug a little bigger than Chicago's. Golden Tate, Hackenberg, and Latavius Murray also out. And so this is where we're going to end the episode, and I want to ask you guys a question from content creator to viewers. If you follow me on Twitter, you guys know that I have kind of reached my wit's end with Madden 18, from the quarterback AI play to play calling. We haven't had a competitive game all year, and the only reason why this score was close against Green Bay was because we got hit with the ALL-MADDEN cheese, with the blocked kick and the fumbles that were all of a sudden happening late in the ball game. Like, I don't know if I can keep playing this game, but if you guys want to see more, I will do my best to power through the rest of the year. We've got a couple of weeks until Madden 19 launches. I would honestly love to just take a break from Madden, give myself a chance to kind of break out of commentary mode for a couple of weeks, and then hop back in the Madden 19 fresh. But obviously, you guys want to see this team raise a Lombardi trophy. Honestly, I just feel like this is getting boring for you guys to watch, because we're blowing out teams every week. It's honestly getting kind of boring for me to play, which is why I made a couple bad reads this game. But it's not the sliders. They are where they're supposed to be. We've built up this offense to put up a lot of points. We built up this defense to be dominant. And the fact that the AI can't even make a simple throw, or they can't make a play call that's going to move the chains on third down, really frustrates me. And I've just had it up to here with this game. So let me know what you guys think down below. Sorry for the rant to end the episode. If you guys want to see week 12 and the rest of the season continue, let me know. We've got like 7 games minimum between now and the divisional round if we do clinch a first round bye, which we are probably going to do. Like, let's be real here. We're going to win a Super Bowl. It's going to happen. Are we going to lose a game between then? Maybe if we have a bad offensive performance, which I really doubt with this offensive line playing the way they are right now. But obviously, you guys, let me know down below in the comment section what you want to see. I will catch you guys next time, maybe, hopefully. Have a nice day. See you later.